bunch of boys were whooping it up in the Melanie Saloon. The kid that handles the music box was hitting a ragtime tune. Back at the bar in a solo game sat Dangerous Dan McGrew, and watching his luck with his light o' love, the lady that's known as Lou. That was the first paragraph of Robert Service's The Shooting of Dan McGrew. Robert Service was born in Preston, Lancashire, England on January 16, 1874 and died September 11, 1958 at age 84. He was a great poet and is known best for his poems The Cremation of Sam McGee and The Shooting of Dan McGrew. The Bard of the Yukon, people called him.
He came to Canada to pursue his life as a cattle rancher and arrived in Vancouver by train. It was here where he would launch his career in writing, but still seek more adventure. Robert made his way to California, working small jobs to make a living. He only carried a pack sack and a guitar as he wandered around, barely getting by. He made his way from San Francisco back to Vancouver, where he worked as a clerk with the Canadian Imperial Bank of Commerce. A little while later, they transferred him to Whitehorse.
The gold rush still a fresh memory, he jumped on a steamer headed for Skagway, Alaska. He settled in and weaved his way into the social scene, producing a play and reciting ballads he'd wrote throughout his journey. He found his way back to Whitehorse, and those, he wrote, were the happiest days of all. Robert worked tirelessly on writing and even drew inspiration from a time when, working late at the bank, another employee mistook him for a burglar and shot at him. Luckily, he missed. In the year 1906, he put his proudest works into a book which he entitled Songs of a Sourdough. The book was a huge hit all across Canada and was also published in the US and UK. Robert would go on to write more and more and meet his wife, Germaine, in Paris. He had twin girls, Doris and Iris, but unfortunately Doris passed away at only a year old from scarlet fever. Robert was a great man who accomplished much, much more than he ever thought he would. At the time of his death, his first book had sold 3 million copies worldwide.